everybody. Welcome to my first video tutorial. I wanted to show you how to strip furniture. Now, obviously, this is just a small piece of wood that's been painted a few times, and I wanted to strip it to show you how that process goes. Hopefully, in the future, I can show you on a bigger piece that might need this, but I didn't have anything that needed to be stripped, and I was eager to show you this process. So, what we're going to be using today is Citrus-Strip Safer Stripping Gel. This stuff is good to use indoors. It says safe for indoor use, no harsh fumes, strips multiple layers at once. You're still going to want to use gloves, even though it's a safer material than the normal stripping liquids. So I'll put my gloves on, and they've been used many times, so they're quite messy, so pardon that. You can always pour this in either a glass container or a metal container. You won't want to do anything that will dissolve. I have a piece of cloth here, and underneath that I have cardboard for protection. But I'm just going to pour it right on top to not have to use any containers, or just save wherever I can. You're going to want to use a bristled brush and just spread it all over. I probably wouldn't get use gloves for this part, but you just never know. And as much as us painters wash our hands and everything, I just kind of want to protect myself from dry skin sometimes. All right, so it is well saturated. This stuff will start to kind of bubble up. It's probably going to be a little hard for you to see. It's already bubbling up. There's not very many paint layers on this. Supposedly you can put the stuff on and wait 24 hours before you strip it, which is unusual for a lot of stuff. But when there's not a lot of layers, you don't have to wait that long. You can walk away and come back to it. You do want to start to scrape off the paint after all the bubbles have kind of surfaced, because if you let it dry on there, it's going to be really hard to, it kind of gunks up and gets really sticky. And if you wait too long, it'll just stick and you'll really have to scrub to get everything off. I do like it. It can be messy on big pieces. Like I said, it gets really sticky, but it's already started to bubble up. You might just test it on a part. See, I think it's ready to come off. So all you do is start to scrape and it comes right off. I'm using foil, probably kind of loud. I had a styrofoam plate and it started to eat through it. So I don't have any paper plates, which I think would be fine. So I'm just using some foil. On some parts it's not coming off. That's okay. If it's not coming off, then you can just reapply a little bit more. Some parts are going to be a little bit more stubborn for you. I probably could have waited a little bit longer to do this, and it would have come right off. But not a big deal. I will just add a little bit more. And for some of these little curvy parts, you can get an abrasive pad and kind of dip it in the citrus strip, and just kind of rub it off. I'm gonna add a little bit more here. But like I said, if I would have left this on just a little bit longer, it would have come right off. And I'll go ahead and add it to this little spots that. Once you've scraped it off, you want to kind of really clean off your scraper, because if not, it'll start to like spread again. So sorry about that. But and then this, you just take it right off. And then just clean your scraper. But it's pretty simple. I was a little intimidated by it when I first tried it. And when I first tried it, it was kind of a wreck. because I let it sit too long, and then it just got really hard to work with, which wasn't good, but that's the learning curve. There wasn't a tutorial then, so hopefully, I think there might be some others, but hopefully this will be helpful for you. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. After you're done completely stripping it, you take some soapy water and an abrasive pad and just kind of scrub it so that you get all the stickiness off, and then let it dry and maybe give it a little sanding, and it's good for painting or staining. This still has some of the varnish that was used to protect the wood on it, but if I would have left it longer, it would have come right off. So depending on if you're wanting to stain, you'll definitely want to let it sit for a long time, or until it really starts to get going bubbling before it dries out, and then scrape it off and then sand it, and you'll get bare wood. If you're just wanting to paint but you're trying to get rid of some of the cracked and yucky old paint, then you could probably just scrape off the paint, clean it, give it a good sanding, and it'll be good for painting. All right, thank you for watching. Have a blessed day.